Hey, welcome to the sports show here on Sportsnet GHTV with me, Eli Kondo. You know, on the sports show, we dig into the past, we discuss the present, and you know what? We predict the future as well. So today, I'm here with an important guest, I'll tag him, and he's going to be digging out a lot and presenting to us a lot more interesting issues. Reason you don't need to step away, stick with us and enjoy all of it right here with me, Eli Kondo. So today, obviously, it's a sports personality, yes. And it happens to be the person of Fatau Dauda. They call him the Lion. Fatau,
what's up?
Thanks for being with us today.
Welcome.
Aside the Lion, which other nicknames do you have?
Well, if you are from Madina, then you can call me Ezo or Zozomi.
Hey, Zozomi?
Ezo or Zozomi, yeah. So sometimes when I'm in town, I hear that name. I tell my back after the other, I'm speaking to someone I know.
Okay.
In Madina. But that name, if you don't know in Madina, you don't know that name.
Does that mean you grew up in Madina?
I was born in Madina, not in Madina.
Wow. So, how many siblings do you have?
Yeah, I have five, and six, four boys, four strong boys and 2 years.
Are you the eldest?
I'm the third.
Wow. So, how many of you play football in the family?
Yeah, we are three. One is head, so he's not playing anymore. So, my general manager, Zach, he used to play for Texas.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's still playing?
He's still playing, but he's not in the gyms anymore.
Okay. But did your father or your parents endorse you guys to play football when you were in?
Well, you know, the parents were to go to school and they go to Arabic school. That's the Arabic school, the Makara town, where they used to go. But when we were young, where I live in Madina, I just live closer to the Madina Polyclinic.
Okay.
There's a food there. Go down for the upper sport KQ. That's the food they used to name the clinic now.
Okay.
It's a food that Goda Bloody, the Preppon, the Mario Circle 4, jumping on Goda Bloody. That's the food they used to play when they were playing Madina. So just by the food, there's a small food there. People used to play this under 12, something like because something changing.
Yeah.
They used to play there. So I remember one Saturday, we used to go to Arabic school, Margaret, on Saturday and Sunday, because we go to school from Monday to Friday. And the Saturday and Sunday, we go to Makarata. So that's when we also play these matches, Saturdays, because during the weekdays,
you're busy
in school. And if you don't go to this Arabic school, you became.
Wow.
Yeah.
How strict?
Just in front of my house, there's a park. We play one Saturday morning, we play this gala. And I also bowled. I did very well that day.
So you're always in pole?
Always in pole.
Why did you choose the goalpost and not play?
Well, I remember one time, there's one guy. His left arm, so rest in peace. He told me to be in the post, and I went to the post, and I was no, I had an interest in more. I want to be a goalkeeper. I started playing goal. So that day I go right well, and then he went to my house. He told me to play. Hey, come and see you. Your son. His team was a lot of crowd. Yeah, and we beat this team. And then that day we won, but I wasn't happy. I was not because I knew. They beat me. They came because I didn't. But not knowing that day, definitely, when they were sharing the food, you know, because they were the
chef,
they gave me a lot of meat because they came to watch the game. They were happy when people were praising me.
And you didn't know they were watching?
I never knew.
Wow.
I never knew because I was busy playing. So that encouraged me to
keep on.
So I remember after school, my mom wanted me to continue the future. I don't know how to play football. Because when I was in school, it was a commercial school, only one commercial school, it was.
Okay.
And I went there, I was still playing. So I played my coach football in Kipus.
Okay.
So after school, I came down and I said, no, football is football. So that's where I started school, that's where I started playing.
Mm-hmm. So how did you graduate into professional football in Kipus?
I remember after Kipus, I came to Accra.
Mm-hmm.
I joined Madina United. That's the club is known by. The late Jordan Anadwa.
Yeah.
And so I was very late, I was young, but the coach knew what I can do, so he just put me there. So by then, second division was like Premier now.
Okay.
By then.
Big.
Very big. But you know, that is why they call me like I'm very scared, I have the heart, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I was there, I started playing there, and I went to, that's second division.
Yeah.
And I went to play for Uvura.
Okay.
In division one.
Mm-hmm.
Before I came and joined
that would have been an interesting climbing.
It's crazy. I have a story to tell somebody. I can't write a book. I'm planning for that because I have a good story that can motivate a long person.
Give us a feeler of how, maybe, yes, you can't reveal everything because there's a book to write, but some of the interesting things that our viewers would like to know, the story coming up from United and all of that.
Everything that you're doing, not in football, everything that you're doing, there are three things that you have to take it seriously. Prayers, dedication, and hard work.
Okay.
That's what I believe in. And it's rare. So after graduate, I want to play for Premiership. Well, I started with post second division.
Yeah.
It's like school. Class 1, class 2, class 6.
Right. Yeah.
So second division, I wanted to play at that level. Yeah. But again, that time it's not easy to get division 1. Not talk about Premiership.
Wow.
So I play and I went to graduate. I played for 3 years. I came to Accra.
Mm.
I started training with better professionals.
Okay.
Just training, but then we have Mr. Bashios, these top guys. But then at some point they put him in the academy.
Okay, wow.
I was there, this Louis Payne, one book.
Yes.
They were there, Kujuado.
Okay.
Kujuado, he took me there to just try my best if he can. I can
but contract. How did you feel going there to be training? You know that this were top guys that are already a team. Did you even think that you could?
Oh, you have to try.
Okay.
You have to believe in yourself and try. I went there and then I was training there almost like 1 month.
Okay.
But I know there's no chance. There are tall keepers there.
Okay.
Top goalkeepers. So I don't know, I have to stop training because I won't get a chance to play. Then one Sumaila was a goalkeeper for Youngsters. So I started training with Youngsters too. I went to Dewu to train with them. But then they also have top goalkeepers. So this Sumaila is playing for Dewu.
Okay.
And he recommended me to go United. Like, we were having justified for inclusion at the Gabriel Wallace, Akuma. So he asked me to coach. I should go and try my life there. So I went there by myself.
Wow.
I went there and justified inclusion. You can imagine. And
a lot of people.
Play a lot. I went there on Monday. That's a third, I remember, third match. It was 6 match holiday. You have to go and play a game at second team.
Okay.
So I went to train with them only 2 days. And I did well. You know, if you know how to play, you don't have to come and play 2 months before people know you, or the coaches, you know. The coaches, they know, they have what they want to see in a player, especially if you are technical good.
Okay.
So they sort of know what they can do. So you have to give them a chance to go and play. But you know, you cannot train and then not play much for a coach to give you a contract. It's difficult.
Okay.
After training, you have to get a test match. So I went to play with Azakis.
Okay.
Only the justified players. We had only one senior player. We went to second DJ Lupac.
Wow.
To play and we had a draw.
That was impressive.
Yeah, so when we were coming, they want us to come to Accra. The following day, just go to FA to do my registration. That's the other book, Mr. Oduna, our general secretary.
Okay.
For going at it.
Oh, wow.
Very tough man. Except for now. And then they're also India. So I'm applying floating letter from Burare because so for some months. They do not pay me, so I need to write for floating. Save for floating letter. So I did that then. But by then, if you apply for floating, it will take like 2 weeks before you get your floating letter. And then the league is about to start.
Wow.
So I told Mr. Odun that was general secretary for Burare. He said, no, it's not a problem. So far, he declared me as a free player. For a letter, it's not a problem. True, I signed a card. By then, I didn't see my contract. Yeah, I want to play for the Premiership.
You want this way to be?
Yes, we have to play.
Wow.
I played for so many games before I had my signing off fee.
Just how much?
I remember 200 cents. Now, that's 2 million. That's now
it's 200 cents.
You know that money? I use the money to buy rubber boots and then conditioning. And then I think I like music. So I bought this. All this whole music, not grinding, because I can't buy grinding. You understand?
What kind of music? You like music. Yeah. So what kind of music do you listen to?
Well, I like, most of the time I like this, I like gospel. I'm a Muslim.
Okay.
But I like gospel.
Why?
Because the West.
Okay.
I like the West.
They're inspiring. Okay.
And then I like dancehall too.
Dancehall.
First time I heard, again, then I heard Stoneboy.
Stoneboy.
I remember then I was in South Africa.
Okay.
His first album, I had one guy there, he lives in South Africa. He knew the scene. I was listening to his album. He is this guy a Ghanaian? He said, yes, he's supposed to be boy. From then to now, I'm Vim Nation.
So Vim Nation?
Vim Nation, Vim Native, yeah.
Vim to the world. Okay, Vim Native.
Native, yeah.
A native of the Vim Nation. Yes. Wow. So what songs do you know of him?
A lot. That guy is talent. For now, Critical.
Critical?
Critical.
He and I think he did that alone?
Yeah, no. He has one lady. One lady.
Mm-hmm. Do you know how it sounds like?
Well, I wish I could play it for you. For you. No, I'm not good at singing.
No, because I just mime how it sounds like, so it remind me of the song.
I'm a who yeah me fell. That's where I remember it. I'm not good at singing.
You're romantic, right? Nice one. Let's get back to your playlist from Marconi United. Now, after you signed and you started playing, how did the journey go like? I'm sure because you got into the basket as well. So from there, what would it be?
Yeah, that's where I started saying that the work of God is improving us. Because I pray, if you are doing something, you have to get integrity.
Yeah.
Do something, even if no one is watching, do it right. God will bless you. I was playing sometimes. I remember that season 2002, we used to play our home matches at Transfer Stadium. Because the Koko Stadium was closed for renovation.
Okay.
We play our matches at Transfer Stadium. So sometimes we play match at home, we lose the game. So when we are going to our win, assume we are going to Obuasi. By then, both of us on their top home. Top players. And the other guys, they were there. So when we are going to our win, sometimes some of the guys will just. We want to go, but you know,
they're afraid of
you. In our home, we are losing ground. But I don't have that thing. I always go to every match. I believe in something that, so far as I want to play, I have to play every game. But I don't know where I will make it.
Yeah.
So I remember one game, we want to, obviously, to play go first. And then that match, before that match was midweek, we played weekend at home, and we lost the game. So when we were going to Obuasi, a lot of the players, the top players, the first team players didn't go.
Because they were afraid they might be eliminated.
Yes. So we went. We went there. I think that match we drew against Bofors.
Wow.
Yeah. And I was the man of the match.
So you made a lot of saves in that
lot. A lot. I remember after the game, this high school supporter, Bofors supporters, they were on me like this. They were giving me money, so we were giving me food and other things. Yeah. And they didn't say, no, they will come from now. For the season.
The fans.
They put their club. They see they play for me.
Wow.
But once you go for fans, they are dread.
So that's the beginning of it.
Yes. So that's 2002. That's my first season playing the Premiership. So we came, things didn't work out. The second season we went.
Mm-hmm.
They beat us 2-0. But that day was even better than
previous
year season.
Wow.
And then they promised me. Come from it. So after the league, I remember I went to Abusukai. That's where they go supporters.
Okay.
That's when we play. I do go there. I have some people when I go there. They give me money. They are good.
Okay.
They give me money. So I was in Abusukai one Saturday and I had a call from Captain Ansa. He was the CEO for Ashby by then.
Okay.
He called me and I'm not talking about that. Yes. So okay. I'm the CEO of Gophers, Ashanti Gold. So I want you to come and play for Gophers. So he started to call it, he wanted to come to Obuasi Monday. That day he called me on Saturday. He said, wanted to come on Monday.
That was a big move.
Yeah, I was like, I started making calls, calling my boss who has trained me. I said, this is what happened. He said, hey, come on. I started buying some things in town. I was in town already. So I have to buy some things. And I came. Then Sunday, the following day was Sunday. I have to go and start training with them on Monday. So I went to Obuasi on Sunday.
Wow.
I started training Monday. I trained for only a week. And I went to do my medicals. I signed a contract and they gave me 1 week to prepare and come back. I signed a contract the day I signed a contract, they gave me my check.
That same day?
That same day. I signed the contract in the office. The CEO asked me to go and see the accountant.
Wow.
As you,
they were serious. Club, yeah.
Professional club. They do everything accordingly. So I went there to see the accountant. The accountant gave me the check. I went to the bank and I was able to cash them.
That same day. Why didn't you wait?
You know what the team is from? It's a mining team.
Okay, so there was money at the
bank. There's a money at the lab. So I went there and they said, I should have some mining card. I did that. And then, less than 20 minutes, I had my cash. I wouldn't have cash better. I just be in the car straight to Accra.
How much was that?
I signed for 3 years. They gave me 14 million. That's 4,000 Ghana cedis.
Wow.
3 seasons. By then, 2004.
Hmm.
So they gave me 2,000. That's 20 million for them.
For the total.
So the second season, before we resumed the season,
mm-hmm.
the balance was in my account already.
Wow, that's professional.
Yeah. Ashwood. It's a professional club.
So when you got that money coming back to Accra, what was the plan? What were you thinking to do with that money?
I was in my dinner by then.
Okay.
Although the house was my father, mm-hmm. and my mother was also having a land. You know, in Accra, you have a land, and the land is empty. Mm-hmm. If you take time, you lose the land.
Exactly.
So she was able to draw something on it, like some cheap two chamber work rooms.
Okay.
So I bought that one, so you know, I have to come and freeze that rooms, and then even build another two.
Wow.
By then, things was not difficult like now.
Okay.
So I did that because I want to leave the family house, mm-hmm. come and live alone. I like living.
Mm, I see.
So I did that, and then so the second season when they gave me the balance, I came in and I completed the house that my mother was waiting for.
Wow, that's a lot of blessings.
Yeah, a lot. But the house now, she's now even renting the house and then enjoying the rent.
Mm.
It's a blessing.
Exactly. Well, you're listening to an interesting story from Black Stars goalkeeper. Who's seen it all in terms of domestic and international football. Fatal Data and the best thing here on Sportsnet GHTV. We get to dig into all of the past, which you've heard already. We're going to be discussing the present as well and also predict the future. I'm sure maybe he'll be a goalkeeper's coach very soon or a business tycoon. Nobody knows. But we'll find out all of that in a bit. So stay with us.
Your dreams can come true at Lakeside Estate with 24-hour security, a police station and a serene environment. Lakeside Estate gives you the house of your dreams as well as absolute peace of mind. Make the move today. Move to Lakeside Estate.
So still now, Ashwood became your club, your dream club, because it was one of the world's spoken teams there. And you got the good money as well. How did your link through the Black Stars come up?
Yeah, this. I think I'm saying it's a grace because I was invited to the Olympic team.
Okay.
So I actually continued for 9 years.
Wow.
Continuously 9 years.
Nobody was able to take you out.
Okay, I'll say I've been having this in the opportunity to play. A lot of coaches came, you come and go.
Okay.
Kodakan came. Mm. I was there with Jojo.
Yeah.
Tough.
He was. Yeah. Exactly.
Jojo was playing for Nishan. I was not playing for Nishan. Kodaka has one philosophy. If you are doing well,
mm-hmm.
if all of you are doing well, you need all of you equal
opportunity.
Mm-hmm. So I remember one game, trying to play, I was on the phone, George was on the phone, and then he has to call us in his room to toss a coin three wow. times. He told us he's going to toss this coin for 3 times. Whoever wins
twice,
he's going to be equal. He tossed the first one.
Did he tell you that before you got
yes.
to the room?
Yes. Okay. No, he didn't tell us. He said we should come.
Okay.
So when we came, I was sitting there directly, and then he said, this is what you want to do.
Mm.
I'm doing well, always doing well.
Mm.
So you got a toss coin. Whoever wins, the person will play more that day, that game. It was a midweek match we play against us. And then the weekend we played Africa.
Oh, well, that's big
yes.
games coming up.
So we did that, and then the first one, George won.
Mm-hmm.
I still have
faith.
I know there's two more.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the second one, I won.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one.
What was going through your head when that was happening?
I was like, whatever happened,
okay,
I'll take it.
Okay.
So far as I'm getting, we together, and I won the third one. And
after free spirit.
When that game, we lost 1-0, but tough. It was a good game for me. So I have to continue playing in the weekend with the one local team, West Africa.
Mm.
Okay. Then, so I was like, I was not good. For 9 years playing
wow.
continuously.
Competing with the likes of Jolly Hope, national team leaders.
Abukari Nakani, Isaac Amwakun,
Frank Abdok,
Isaac Akun. A lot of members came
through. Okay.
A lot. Even Joe Samuel came along the line.
But interestingly, you keep surviving because even in the Black Stars, you keep to have that competition with top goalkeepers, but you keep surviving and still maintain your place. What is the secret?
You know, in the Splendid Camp, I'm playing for them, kind of friendly in football. Football. One thing you have to believe is work hard, focus, and wait for the opportunity.
Okay.
Especially in the national team.
Mm-hmm.
If you get an opportunity like that, you don't make use of it. You have to go back and join the queue. Because there are a lot of players.
Yeah, the list is a lot.
So I was prepared. I was prepared every time the chance comes. I'll do it.
So after that international game, Moroccan side, Ashko, was that where the Blasters connection came from?
Yeah, we started playing these cup games, these continental games.
Mm.
And then I had a call to join the
national team. The Olympic team.
So I was there, we were playing the qualifiers to Beijing.
Okay.
Beijing Olympic, I was in the team. But by then, they do camp for so many months. So they were in camp for so many months before I joined them. By then, Rekliba was a warm up for them.
Okay.
But Joe started with him, so rest in peace. He invited me, so not, I can help.
Mm-hmm.
So I came and he told me that Niba is the number one. I'm going to go back. So he even said that to me before we started the training. So I was in my mind that no.
Yeah, me too.
I'm not too, but I'm still working here.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't worried because I know at least I'm in the team.
Yeah.
You have a lot of good players and you have a chance to join the national team. Why not? Yes, work hard and wait for the opportunity. So before I joined the team, they gave me a chance to be able to play the friendly game. Berlin, the Berlin national team, they went there, they beat them, you just have more and other guys. That's where I had a chance to stay in the Olympic team. So we played a qualifier, went to South Africa, we beat South Africa 3-1. I was the team, we came back, we beat them 3-1, we played up that game, that one.
Okay.
And then the last game, we played Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
And they are having one outstanding match in South Africa. But our last game was to beat Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
We did win the qualifier. I remember that game, a day before the game, the minister, already that time, who was the minister right by then, he came to visit us at the stadium.
Mm-hmm.
He promised us if you win that game, I will go to school again, 4,000. Because at that time, if you win the match, it's $2,000.
Okay, so
double. That match, double. $4,000 can be a lot of things that time.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, my first time getting bonus, mm-hmm. $4,000 is when you beat South Africa. That's it.
Yeah.
You won the deal with $2,000. We came when they give us. That's when I started seeing
dollars, big money.
Big money. So the minister came and said, if you win this match, because if you win, you are going to the big games.
Exactly.
4,000. Nigeria came with frustrated us. We had a draw. Because they were also looking for a draw.
Mm.
That match against South Africa, they are playing it in home. Just imagine. And I go,
it would be easy for them.
It would be easy for them. And then they had a draw. They started relating. But they know they will win that South Africa match. But that match, if South Africa should beat Nigeria, even 100-0, you know, qualified. So, we couldn't qualify. A lot of jihad. You had a great squad and then top squad. Even some of the guys are in the national team. And then, that's ending of 2007. That's around November.
Yeah.
And 2008 is AFCON.
Yeah.
Ghana is hosting.
Yeah.
And Ghana is playing these four nation tournaments in Ghana.
Yeah.
I think Dubai also.
Yeah.
So, we were training in the stadium, like Accra Sports Centre, we start training around 3. Last time we come and train around 5.
Okay.
But then Savage and Richard. And Savage, yeah, Richard Kingsley was in town, was in camp. But Savage, and he said he was playing a game. He would report to the camp after the game.
Okay.
So when he went to train, he only had one.
Okay.
Goalkeeper. So, Claude Roy asked Sabakwe, he was a team manager for us, that
mm-hmm.
went one goalkeeper from the Metros to join the team. Because Niba is going to play in goal against Nigeria. Mm-hmm. They asked me to do what? To stay and train with
the Blasters.
That's where the break took time.
Yeah.
I started training with them. Mm-hmm. We finished training,
mm-hmm.
they would go to camp and I'll stay, wait for the Blasters to train with them. I was not taking on the fatigue. Wow. No. Even training with the Blasters alone, it's good for me.
Mm-hmm.
I was not thinking of even joining the team to play every match. I was number two. Mm-hmm. Not to talk about if they want to take, they will take the number one to get on.
Exactly.
But I was not thinking that. So they, I stay and train with them like three times. You know, but then they like me shooting, but all of them were in season.
Mm-hmm.
So they don't need any tough training, just something to be
light.
Yeah. So they were doing a lot of shooting. But then to when people started training across the world, a lot of fans.
Mm-hmm.
So they were shooting, I was saving. The supporters started.
Acrobatic saves. Then you had a long stretch.
They encouraged me the
questions.
Mm-hmm. You know, and the white man, Leroy. So after I stopped, I went to Samuel Jimmy before they came. So after our game, I came to watch the formation. Okay. I went to the wrestling guests. You know, because I came with them for twice, they were friendly.
Yeah, okay.
So I went to them, said, hey, how are you? So this heavy runner was a physical trainer.
Exactly.
So he told me that, Dauda, keep working, okay? You'll be the professional designer, you'll be the next month. So a month later, so after everything, I went back to Wasi to join my club.
Okay.
We were in the bus one morning going to Tamale to play a league game with our team. And I had a call from Jasapa. You know, we used to stay in Medina.
Okay.
So he called me like, he heard some rumor that there would be some 45-man professional system. So the bookkeepers have been me, myself, Rokote, Asika Maku, Madeira, the common one, left Ashwood, joined the top form. Rokote, Asofo, top form. And then myself, I was like, hey, no, this one, I don't believe. So less than 1 hour, we're in the bus, getting ready to go. And then the driver just put there. Because you know, footballers, you know, you
sports.
But then sports is for people, you listen to sports. And they started mentioning the names. And through my name, popped me. Said, wow, they said they're going to go to Dubai for camp. So I was thinking, like, all the 45
people
were going to go to Dubai. I was like, no, this one, I'm not sure. So we went to the game, we came. And then my CEO, Mr. Shano, called me. I was sleeping, we went to train. So I came back, I was sleeping. Me, if I'm sleeping, I'll put my phone in time.
Silent, you don't want to step up.
So, where we live is a quarters. So, I live with our team driver. This is the next apartment. So, he came to knock my window. And I looked at him and said, Mr. Flamme was calling back. I said, okay, okay. So, he said, I should call him. So, I called him and he said, they need my passport in the airfield.
Wow.
I need to bring the passport. And I'm in Owasi. I can't come to Accra. So, I need to send one boy. To give him direction. The boy is clever enough and give me the direction to Accra. He presented my passport to Mr. Alessa Santi.
The FA.
And the FA. And then he called me out to him. He gave me the passport. Okay. So I think 2 days, 3 days, so we're going to meet in Accra. We have some small dinner before we go to Dubai.
Wow.
But I don't know, I was not being like.
You're still not believing in
it. They can't take 5 years to Dubai.
But why aren't you believing in it? Because, yes, your name is Lele, it's a professional, you've already gone home.
That's why I say, if God wants to do something, you do it. You don't believe it.
Yeah, unexpected.
Unexpectedly.
Mm.
But one thing that helped me, for me, I was always ready for anything.
Good.
So I came to Accra, I went to Osu, to have some small, you know, the professionals that are down by them. Because most of them came from their club, they joined
Europe.
They joined the team camp in Dubai.
Right.
So we went to Dubai, we went to Dubai, and I said, I'm only the local by there. First day, second day, third day. 1 week, I was like, ah, why did I have to do this? My then, Samuel Jimmy, which are automatic.
Mm.
So, they will take only one out of these three local people. What? I can't see this boy. They are also local people.
I say, Ken.
And I feel from Ghana to Dubai. Not that they are playing
abroad.
Or maybe they are playing legally with Ghana. Yes. So, 1 week, second week, I said, no. And maybe I'm not sure. Maybe I'm going to be there.
Okay.
That's how it happened. It came to Ghana.
Did you find out why you weren't there?
That's not my problem. I was just focused doing my training. You understand? Mm. Even for me that time, I feel like maybe the pandemic, I don't know.
What's it? You're okay.
I'm okay.
Wow.
Yeah. That's
so
how it is.
So 2008 AFCON.
I was in the squad. You know, the national team has done a lot for me. We were winning games, the bonus was coming. Me, my dad had a house, although it's not a big house, it's a family house, my mom has, but I still want to pay because I know I'm not the only child.
Okay.
So I think the 2008, the money I had, I built it. That's my first house.
Okay.
Around hometown.
Wow.
I built the house and then, I have some small car or something, some small golf.
Mm.
Definitely I have to drive because I've been working for long. And to drive and make my rounds easy.
Okay, sure.
I didn't use the money to go and buy hammer, BMW, small golf, or a car that I can maintain.
Exactly.
Because I look at my salary and that's good.
Yeah.
If this goes for you, I can do maintenance. Exactly. So that if you want to buy a car, you have to
think about
the maintenance, it's very important. So I had some small golf. And then since from 2008, since from then, I was out from the national team. Till 2012, November.
Why was that?
I don't know.
Because
that one, I don't know.
You were still active.
I don't know. No one. But I think it's all the work of God.
Did you feel discouraged at any point? Did you feel that, well, it wasn't yours to be in there?
I was there after a couple of days. I would say, like, if I didn't go to the mission, I'm okay.
Your dreams can come true at Lakeside Estate with 24-hour security, a police station, and a serene environment. Lakeside Estate gives you the house of your dreams as well as absolute peace of mind. Make the move today. Move to Lakeside Estate.